I've owned this Vivo Mini Metal lathe for over a year now, and having used it extensively over that period of time, I want to update you and share my thoughts on the machine, what I like about it, some of the things that I dislike, answer some of the questions that were brought up in the comments section on my first video on this machine, whether I think it's a worthy purchase, and lastly, we'll make a compression test adapter, and I'll use the lead screw and the change gears to single point thread on the machine as well. And as always, I've put links to this lathe and many of the other tools that I use in the description below for you. As a small engine mechanic, anything and everything that I've wanted to make on this lathe, I've been able to do so, either because those parts are no longer available, they didn't necessarily fit my needs, or I simply needed a tool to be able to complete the job that I'm working on. I've machined everything from custom piston rings from scratch from cast iron. I've been able to make non-return valves for fuel systems. I've machined intake manifolds, spacers, shims, nuts, bolts, seal install tools, punches, other hand tooling, and I've even machined and made my own part for a Stihl MS660 oil pump. And not only have I made these parts, but I've been able to hold incredibly tight tolerances down to within a few microns. The lathe is quiet. It's got infinitely variable speed from 0 to 22,500 RPM. And for the price that you pay, it's just incredible the value that you get. Now the downside, it didn't come perfect out of the box, and it did require me to shim and adjust and add parts like a lathe carriage stop, as well as create stops for the cross slide as well. But these things are so easy to do, to be able to rectify. It doesn't take any specialist tools and only takes about an hour or so to do. One of the major concerns that kept coming up in the comments section to that previous video were the nylon change gears. People felt that they wouldn't hold up over time and that ultimately they weren't suitable for the machine. And that's just not been my experience at all. In fact, anytime I do get a bad catch, typically with the parting tool, we've got a bit of a love-hate relationship, I find that the belt will always slip first. And even with the extensive use that I've put on this lathe, I haven't had a single tooth that's broken, I haven't had any wear on any of the gears, and there's no cracking on them either. However, if that doesn't convince you and you're still not happy with using those nylon gears, you can actually buy metal replacements. They're not expensive and they're easily accessible as well. Machining on a metal lathe, in the context of what we will use it for, making parts and repairing our small engines, it's not a steep learning curve. You'll be able to create some incredibly useful tools and parts within a very short period of time. And even a hack like me can do it. There's not going to be any doubt that you will be able to as well. And whenever I think of the machine or I know that I've got a project coming up, it gives me that buzz of excitement to just get some metal on the lathe and start turning. So that's what we'll do now. Let's get onto the lathe. So the first thing I've done here, I've placed the adapter into the chuck and I've placed some feeler gauges under the jaws to get as small of a run out as possible. This is a three-jaw chuck and therefore they're not known for giving you great run out clearances, so it's fine. We're now about 0.01 millimeters of run out. That's more than acceptable. So now what we need to do is to take down the outer diameter, which is currently M14 by 1.25. We need to take it down to 9.88 millimeters. For such an affordable lathe, the surface finish is absolutely beautiful. You really can't fault it, especially on these softer materials. The measurement with the camera in the way is a little bit tricky, but 10.523. So we've still got about another, just over half a millimeter to go. We are 9.889. I was aiming for 9.884. What, 5 microns out is absolutely fine. So let's now form the gutter for the threads to fall into, and then we'll change the gears. So before I take this cover off, you can see for a 1 millimeter pitch, the gears A, B, C, and D need to be 60, 45, 30, and 60 teeth respectively. A, B, C, and D gears, and they're just held on with simple Allen keys, which we can then swap out. The last thing we'll do is loosen up this nut and this nut and bolt up here, and that's going to allow us to adjust and reposition those gears once we've changed them out. So the gears all have numbers on, they're quite hard to see, but if you get it in the right light, you can see that it says 60 or Z60. 60, 45, 30, and 60. They now need to go on. 45 next. On there, that's nice. 30. And then lastly, we have our 60. Now we need to mesh them together. A bit tough to get in with a spanner, but that's good there. And we'll just check that these teeth are meshing. So there and there. And we don't want too much force between these gears. That's just right. One small addition we'll add is just a little bit of a lead in here. So I've just swapped the tool out. And that should just assist in those threads going in. So now we're going to zero out our cross slide. There, give us a little bit of clearance. And we'll do a scratch pass. And we'll just check that with a gauge. It's going to be quite hard to see, but if I lay my 1 millimeter pitch gauge over that scratch, you can actually see that it lines up really nicely. So now we're at the end of the scratch pass. Never disengage the half nut. By doing so, you will create threads that are uneven. We're currently on zero on the cross slide. We're going to back the cross slide out by a full rotation. That's going to give us our clearance away from those threads. We now turn the lathe in the opposite direction, and we now turn the motor on, and it will come back away from those threads without touching them. We now go the forward direction to the left. We go back in until we get back to our zero point, which was our scratch pass. And now let's add on, I don't know, 0.1 of a millimeter, a really shallow depth. So we'll go 0.1. And now we're going to continue by turning the motor on. It's going to cut that 0.1 depth. Stop the lathe. We've continued to stay on top of that initial scratch pass, and we repeat that process over and over until we get to the depth that we want. So we've gone in exactly 0.6 of a millimeter. So technically, we should be very, very close. We might just need to do maybe one more light pass and possibly go over it with a file. Look at that. Very, very good. That's fantastic. And we'll just put the thread gauge on it. It should be clearer for you to see now. I've replaced the O-ring and the Schrader valve, so it's now ready to be installed on a Stihl MS201T. Fortunately, the internals are far better than the external of this machine. And as mentioned, I've put links in the description below for the lathe, as well as all the other tools that I use in today and my other videos as well. And on the topic of test adapters, there's one that's incredibly important whenever repairing and testing small engines. I've got that in a video on how to make one up here for you next.